front to back, and other words, blank, if you want to take notes on. We can go through anything that you want to see tonight. Also, hurry guys, hey, stay quiet please. Coach Kirby is going to be filming this, so let's get, see how many good passes we have fucked up. Anyway, Coach Kirby is filming this. He'll give you his account, and you guys will be able to look that up. You can look at any of these drills. We're going to kind of show the high school guys tonight. Hey, hold the basketballs really quick. We'll show the high school guys, and we'll go through any drills that you want. If you want me to go top to bottom, I can do that. I have some guys that have been at both of our little coaching sessions, so I was even going to start with a more of a team drill and then show a little more of the offense with these guys. These are some of our upperclassmen with a couple of younger guys in there, okay? I'm going to start with one drill then. It's called swing the ball drill. Hey, come down here. Let's get it four lines. We both have the there except one. I'll take one basketball. If you look at that sheet of paper, it's a larger font. I'm going to do swing the ball drill, then we'll show some of these sets then, 5-0, where they're just swinging the ball. Coach Hoffman, are they organized? Let me get somebody to just get them organized in the other gym so they have a game going. We're going to have to watch it just a little bit. All right, so four ropes. One, two, three, four. Make sure the line's ready. To me, this is probably the most important concept for the team's back. We need to swing the basketball. So I'm the post player. That's what you would do as the coach. Okay, the players have to learn, you know, they're going to B-cut them, so we can hold the ball a little bit more on the wings. We want quick swings in from, again, the edge of two extended. All right, so here we go. Swing the ball, B-cut. Okay, go. Swing. We always have the outside hand. We're going to turn our hands. Keep going, move up and down the lane. Good. A lot of these guys have done it. Some of them have never done it. Some of them have done it last year. Now, once I show my hands, Jimmy, you should know this drill. Once I show my hands, my chest, throw the ball to them. Okay? Do it again. They didn't pick me up. Go. Again, I'm the post guard. I'm just trying to follow the basketball. Always hit the target hand. Always hit the target hand. All right, so you hit it, and this one goes out. They go to different lines. They get four centers. Go. Be good. If you guys can get up and down the lane, say their name. these guys are going to be screening down. Go ahead and screen down. And then now pass the ball to him. And then he would have the option to cut through. Remember this is what I showed last week. Cut through the round. He cut over. He cut out. Okay, I always want them to work. He cuts to get there. Remember, I talked last week about it, 2 weeks ago. If I'm guarding DJ here, if he be cuts, if I'm up too high, he's going to cut back further. Okay, we're going to punish bad defense. That's why even swinging the ball off that throw we just did, I want them coming across straight to the ball so they can either go to the rim or they pop out and they hit that target hit. We catch it, and then we swing the ball even in this. Okay, even in our step. So that four-man swing the ball drill really sets us up for any type of offense we want to run. Okay, I talked about numbers. A great offensive team knows that the first side, most defenses are okay. Well, they're good. Second side, they're okay, then they're pretty average after that. So we know that if we don't have anything, we're going to really look at the first side. It's the second side. A lot of times it's the third side where we get a great one. All right. Let's do it again. Okay, this time we're going to do a little different. I don't want you to cut through. We're going to screen down. We're going to hit the wing. You're going to go pass it right back to Jason. Okay? And the three is ready to go. And now, what we're going to do at this point is you're going to swing the ball, and I want you two to stagger away. Anytime we stagger for a bit, he knows he's curled. I know Noah here, he's about 6'9". No, he can get out there and hit some shots, see what he has. He's going to come off hard to curl. What do we always do after a stagger? Stagger and fade. So I want you to do that into a stagger and fade. All right, what can you do after you either hit here or hit the fade pass? Yeah.
Thank you.
paper. I put my heart and soul as far as what basketball is. 90% of that, 95% of it is straight fundamentals. That was really the first two coaching clinics. I went through so many fundamentals. Okay, but I wanted to do this, at least show this first so you can get a look at it. All right, give me the first one out here. Let's run thumbs up. Thumbs up. All thumbs up means is we have one post player. When they make the pass, that UCLA screen. Nope, come off the screen right away. Okay. We're going to set them up there, and then that shooter is coming off the side of the screen on the other side. And then we set a ball screen right here. Okay, it's the simplicity of that that can be so bad. A shooter coming off the stagger screen, and then we have a big, it's going to set a ball screen, and then roll in the basket. All right, do that real quick. Go!
Thank you.
We did. Okay, you can see we said, I made sure we had both gyms tonight, and they're playing in that gym, and I just want to be able to show this. So, when you see us in a month, we'll be better at this movement. It doesn't matter what we do. Coach Alton's going to come in and show some of our transition sets. It doesn't mean I want you to focus on the fundamentals, and then just find one or two things that you guys can be really good at, and just work on that, and drill it. All right, here we go.
I like how our young guys are always trying to shape up and use their bodies.
You know, we want it to be a physical presence. Again, my first couple years head coach, you know, all of our timeouts, I was the tallest guy. I'm not the tallest guy anymore. Okay, so again, we need to make sure we teach them and train them to use their body. Coach, only quick, would you work with the guards here and work close, and I'm going to have you show that transition. Just show how we can split the guards we work on that, and maybe come for it. And if you go down,
gets them out, going, they run, try to make a play, okay? And then some creative, you know, they involve some creativity and things like that. But you'll see some of the stuff, hopefully you'll see some of the stuff that we emphasize in our half court. Meaning, hey, real quick, give me point, wing, post, other guys. Okay, get those, we talked about this last time. Get those in there, we close the entry. Anytime you close the entry, we're gonna split touch, split screen. They cut through, he fills, cut it out. Okay? They throw it out, they go ball screen. He comes to ball screen, remember, he dribbles away from, away, chase, towards the space. Okay? Now, goes here. Anytime he drives, this post needs to relocate. He drives baseline post, relocates up, he follows. Okay? It's kind of like a ball screen, dribbles away, he shakes. We call this a drift pass. Anytime they drive baseline, we look to go to that opposite corner, and then we have something hot and assist and throw to there. Okay? So out of transition, you might see some of this stuff, and then we get good at it, we don't ever have to call it, they just do it. Okay? When you're doing, when you want to do your practice and your transition, you can also incorporate free throws. Hey, hold up, hold up. On the way down, one to two, two baseline drives, on the way back, one.
Five and down sprint. Now, if they get older, maybe even by the end of
split cut or split screen from the guy you threw it in. Okay?
Alright, hey, let's do this.
On the way down, one, bring it all the way down, throw it to the two, yell stagger away. Come off the stagger, make the shot. On the way back, hit the 5-inch position. Okay?
Repeat the question.
Huh?
Repeat the question.
He said inbounds under your basket with the ability to score. I wish I'd done with our older guys. Really, we do box or we'll do flat or baseline.
Wait. figure eight.
Out of the truck, go. Head up. See the guy across the circle from you.
That's right.
Figure eight, please.
Now,
go.
Now figure eight. Yeah. There you go.
Wait, 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 wait. Out of the truck, go.
When they're doing this, you must tell them to keep
right
their head
right
up.
Foot, go.
You have to see the floor.
Head up, head up, head up. You're not looking at that basketball. Head up.
Keep your head up. It's okay if they lose the ball. That's why we're in practice. Make them better. We're looking at the ball.
Left foot, go. Go down the left foot. Down the left foot. There you go. Head up.
Guys are embarrassed about not being able to do this because they keep looking at the ball that's going against the intent of the drill. If they're losing it, that means they're probably getting better. If they're not losing it, it probably means they're looking at the ball. Feel. Don't look. Feel.
All right, down through. What you're doing is getting here. calls in, then we'll get into our pass and drill. Everybody got a marker? One basketball, one two, one side of the other.
Catch on a 2 foot jump stop, right there. Very good.
Every time.
Practice doesn't make perfect. Perfect practice makes perfect.
Thank you.
Faking to his hands and go the opposite. So if his hands are down, fake into his down hands and throw a chest punch by his ear. If his hands are up, fake into his hands and throw a bounce pass low. So watch the defender's hands in the middle here.
Work on it in the sixth grade, they can do it by seventh and eighth grade, and they're really good by the time they get to high school. Some of you guys didn't ever play in our feeder program, so they're still working on their off camp. All right, guys, take your hands and go off. Ready? Defense.
Hands are up and down. Go. Good. See, hands are down. Take in, tell them to go. Hands are down, go up. Hands are up, bounce back. Hands are down, well, up. Hands are down, up. Hands are up, well.
Okay, now this time we're going to switch every time. Play defense, and you pass and follow your pass. If your hands are either up or down. Okay, again, take those hands off. Go.
Go high. High, low. Low, high. Low, high. High, low. There you go. High, low.
Good. Take your hands.
Right by their ear. It's almost like Coach Wynn has done this before.
It's a back door cut. Just lay your basketball down. If I'm here, remember this is also out of that open. Not both up here at all. We're doing a drill. So if I'm dribbling at you, you either dribble weave or you cut back on. Cut back on. Here, and that is the bounce pass. I would want when he's cutting back on.
This battery may go.
Guys,
get
back to the edge of the tube.
I thought I had
it. If they get a tip on the basketball, they get thrown off.
If it goes out, my bad.
Okay. So, I want to press the defense, guys. Get all over them, shadow the basketball. Ready? Go!
That's when it's good.
Go up, go three. Go back first. Go back first.
catches it, he gets the pass. The guy that made the pass goes back into the middle. Can't get out of the middle until you touch it.
All right, hold up, everybody, baseline. Hustle, get on the baseline. If you never
he's got to get back. Run, run, run. See the ball. See the ball. It's because you run.
Hey, again, we're coming back here. Protect the paint. Hold basketball. Okay, so if he's coming in here, I'm going to fake.